Welcome back. So these next pair of shoes that we're going to be reviewing are a little bit, it's like an alternative shoe to review, which, you know how I do on this channel. I don't always like to review the same thing over and over, the you know, Nikes and the Jordans and the Yeezys and the Adidas, but also the shoes that I, you know, collect that I feel like is going to look good on the toe. So let's get into it. All right, folks, so what we're looking at today is going to be the Clark's original Levi shoes. These particular shoes are called, these are the Ventures Clothing Desert Boot shoe, pale blue colorway. So yeah, let's go ahead into it right quick. Now I'm gonna put this down and then I will show you all the shoe as I talk about the information itself here. Now, let's go ahead into it. In the late 80s, Manchester, alternative rock collided with dance culture, creating a whole new scene. The sound grew stronger and the style became more bolder, and the footwear of choice was Clark's. Now, Clark's joined forces with Levi's Ventures Clothing for a fiercely original collection that captures the bright, bold acid house vibes of a bygone era. Now, for this particular shoe here, every design detail that you see is true to the first pioneering pair, crafted with clean lines and enhanced with premium mixed texture suede and natural full grain reverse and the co-branded footbeds, fobs, and the Levi's label tabs. The one thing I do particularly like about this shoe is the color, of course, and just the materials. So let's go back to me right quick. I'm holding the sleeve of the box, as you can see here, boom, boom. Not really much to it. All right, we got the Clark's original box here. I will show y'all the box. We don't put it on feet, but it's all about presentation. It's like you go to a nice upscale restaurant, you want that presentation to be lovely, right? you don't want it to just be, here's the food, have a good day. The presentation matters as well. We got the Clark's original here. As you can see, let's take a look at the bottom. Recyclable materials used to create the box, which is what's up. Cool. Let's open that box up to reveal the shoe. Yet again. Now, yes, there's some paper up here, but that's just because, you know, these have been dead stock, honestly. I have not worn these yet. I waited until I actually reviewed the shoe, which is now. So yes, I've had these for some months, but you know, things just come up sometimes, and what I'm doing is just removing the sticker down here. I hate when that happens. Sticker ripped a little bit, but that's cool. Usually what I do is just put the sticker on the insole or right there on the shoehorn, if it comes with a shoehorn, and that's it. So all right, but yes, got the Clark's original here, Levi's Ventures Clothing right here, so that's cool. The inside of the shoe, which you see here, nice. And like I said before in my first video, or the most recent video, if you hear my wife singing in the background, hey, other people live here too, you know what I'm saying? So it ain't just me always in the quiet of the background or whatever, everybody sleeps. Sometimes you gotta do this during the daytime, because that's what the schedule allows. Yeah, this is like a nappy hair suede is what I like to call it here. And then you got your low hair suede right here. So that's really good here. Definitely like that. Let's bring it up closer so you can see the color transition of that suede as well. So that's good. And you can see it right here on the toe box as well. So that's pretty good there. What I do particularly like about this shoe is this right here. This just kind of gives it a nice aesthetic pop with that nice like lilac or lavender or purple colorway of the laces to the shoe itself here. And of course, I do like that part too, the purple Levi's tag. Now, I'm not a huge fan of Clark Wallabies. I had two pair before and I'm like, yeah, I'm over it. and I know it's the prime footwear for Ghostface Killer, you know, who is a part, of course, part of the Wu-Tang Clan. And I'm a huge fan of Wu-Tang. Like, Wu-Tang's for the children, definitely for the babies. I'm a huge fan of Wu-Tang. It's just, when it comes to those Wallabies, I was like, yeah, I can't do it. Can't do it, Ghost. I had a pair of the original, like, well, you see it on the screen right there, the original Wallabies. Not original, but had came out a few, what, 2 years ago? Of those shoes. And then I was like, yeah. And then I ended up selling them to my boss, because he's Wu-Tang forever as well. Definitely a huge Wu-Tang fan. And then I had got another pair, which are like a cream, like a caramel cream mix, you know what I mean? And that was like straight off the Wu-Tang site. And then I was like, okay, yeah, you know, the one about a good once, twice, three times a lady. And then I was like, yeah, I'm out. I can't do this. For me, it just didn't feel right on foot, you know what I mean? But these right here, I've put these on before now, and I feel like, well, we'll see in the on foot, but these definitely are hidden. Let us get the box up here. So y'all can see that right quick. Sleeve back on it. See, no cuts, no edits to a degree. To a degree. There we go. Put this right here. Boom. So, right shoe over there, left shoe here. You can see here. Let's get this tag off. Maybe this tag will go off a little bit easier than the last tag, so I'm going to actually rip. And, nah. Nope, this one is stuck on the bottom. Yep, and it rips anyway. That's cool, no problem. So you can see on the outsole, the material, durable, easy to stop you from skipping or slipping, I should say. You can skip if you want to, but I wouldn't want to do it in these boots. Yeah, I feel like these are premium materials for the most part. And they weren't expensive, definitely not expensive. Yeah, these are retail. So if you're able to get a pair, you can do so either. You might be able to get some on GOAT or StockX. I don't think so though. Probably eBay might be your best bet. If you are looking to try to pick these up, they might have some in other stores. For me, I had to go to a website through UK to be able to get them. And I had to order them in UK 11, which for US size is US 12 men. So they fit me just fine. But folks, this is Takisa. Appreciate y'all allowing me to show y'all these alternative shoes rather than just the regular sneakers I always review. If you would, please make sure to like, share, and subscribe. You know, send it to those out there who's looking for something a little bit different than just a basic sneaker. And of course, if you have any questions, you can hit me up on Instagram. More than happy to answer your questions. But let's go ahead and get on our feet. Appreciate y'all, you know, taking your time to watch the video. And I will see y'all on the next review. Bye. What's the break? I can back a roll, I can stove it. With St. Joseph, with red tops in front of roses, had a full energy. Turned to 90, called it culture. Pop pioneers had the suplex of soda. Raided the duplex, the missus by a quota. Let the man go off the track, hawk, do it on his whole shoulder. Let the niggas all know. You better know it's ya. You better know it's ya. You better know it's 4 pounds on your forehead. Your mind off your shoulders. Be the greatest. Beef like EB Greens, kill him on the wake up. Hip hop the sales, Lord, love your neighbor. Put you out to misery. The only boxing I'ma be in is 63. Been in school too long, I want a dealer key. I want to feed all the fam, I want my man to eat. I got some niggas that I miss, but we ain't never speak. My nigga praying for the world, let my nigga free. Let my nigga free.
If I lost shine, cutter gon' shine, it's mathematical. Peace, God, keep your head up on your sabbatical. JLX Griselda could finally enter the chat with that skrrr, all over the track, spitting actual facts. Sir, the originator was black. From Buffalo to Tupelo, we trying to break from the trap. You should read theology, your time as your days blow.